Should I get a hair transplant? I'm 29 years old right now, and I started to lose my hair when I was 21 years old. Can you guys suggest to me what I should do?
Thank you for your question. You've submitted a single photo, and your question describes a history where you started losing hair at 21 and you're now 29 years old, and you're asking for advice. Well, understanding that male pattern hair loss, which is what you appear to have, has a family history or a tendency to run in families, the level of progression you have, clearly you can project that within a few years you will have much less hair. And when you think about hair loss options, going over that first is very important, and then I'm going to discuss with you a relatively new idea that we have been in a leadership position in to that might be appropriate for you. So let's begin with male pattern hair loss and what are the medical interventions available. There are two drugs. One is finasteride and the other is minoxidil. Finasteride is a pill that's taken daily, and it inhibits an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. 5-alpha reductase is responsible for the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. It's been shown that there are specific segment of men who have hair follicles sensitive to the effects of dihydrotestosterone. And when finasteride was introduced, a lot of men benefited and continue to benefit from taking daily finasteride. At this time, there's a lot of concern about the long-term sexual side effects of finasteride. And in our practice, it is more typical for men in their 20s and 30s to come in and categorically refuse to even consider taking finasteride. The other drug is minoxidil. Minoxidil is a topical treatment that helps prolong the presence of hair that's thinning and is something that is applied once at night. Now, traditionally, the only other alternative to these medical interventions was a hair transplant. And unfortunately, many younger men went forth with getting hair transplants, but the reality is that a lot of younger men who have this rapid progression of hair loss, after one transplant, they needed another transplant and then another one. Well, unfortunately, the donor area, the area in the back of the scalp, is very limited, and you cannot cover the space that was once covered with tens of thousands of hairs with only a few thousand hairs. And so you end up having this look of looking like you had a transplant. And this is a big, big concern. What we have been doing in our practice for someone like yourself, and I'll just share with you how we would handle the situation when someone like you comes to our practice. We have developed a method of using a material called extracellular matrix combined with platelet-rich plasma, and we have used it to inject under the skin of the scalp a single treatment session that has effectively stopped the progression of hair loss as well as reversed the thinning process and thickened up the thinning hair. We have approximately 3 to 5 years of data, and we have been very successful with close to 100% response rate with male pattern hair loss, and we're even developing newer protocols for men with more advanced hair loss in terms of later stage procedures, in terms of injection. However, this procedure has turned out to be remarkably successful, and people are coming to us from all over the world for this treatment. this material that was originally used for wound healing, derived from pig bladder, to help cells heal by duplication of cells. It's not by duplicating hair follicles. That's not what we're doing. It appears that what we're doing is we're restoring the cells and signals necessary for the hair growth process to occur. Unfortunately, hair loss research has been limited in providing answers to how the hair follicle functions. And so this happened to be a serendipitous discovery that has turned out to be a godsend for patients who come to us from all over the world. So I think that this is something for you to learn about and strongly consider. A lot of younger men also don't respond to oral drugs like finasteride. It seems like their hair loss pattern is of a different variety. Finasteride does not work for everyone, which leaves you with just this progressive hair loss. So consider this treatment, and we call it hair regeneration. And this hair regeneration treatment has been very successful, and as a single treatment, and we follow our patients very closely. We see them at 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, all the way up to 18 months at the present time. And to ensure that we are able to follow them carefully and see improvement. So with all this information, I think you need to do some more research and learn more about your options. But I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. And thank you for your question.